Your Dropbox is full. Your iCloud's full. Frame.io's full. Your Google Drive's full. It doesn't matter how much you buy, you're always going to run out of cloud storage. I used to work at one of the most successful cloud companies for creative professionals in the world. And I realized that even though the cloud is great to distribute video, it was never built to work with video. Your camera files are too big, internet's too slow, and cloud storage is too expensive. That's why most people that use cloud tools can only afford to put maybe 10% of their total media in a cloud. It's likely that 90% of the media you own lives on a hard drive or a bunch of hard drives, which means that media is really difficult to remotely access. But what if you could access 100% of your media, even archives from years ago that span dozens of drives, all without having to pay for cloud storage? That's why we created Strada. Strada allows you to connect any hard drive, big or small, and with a simple checkbox, turn that drive into a remotely accessible cloud so you can securely share any file you want with anyone you want, anywhere you want. Strada lets you literally access hundreds of terabytes of media with no uploading, no storage fees, and no limits to how many people can access it. And today, we have two big updates that just went live. Introducing Strada Invites and Transfers. Starting with Strada Invites, now you can connect any drive to your computer, share that drive as a cloud, and invite anyone on your team to access it without having to upload anything. To do this, select the drive and click on the plus button in the top of the media pool. This shows me who has access to the drive and allows me to invite new users. Adding user emails at the root of the drive like this means I want these people to have 100% access to the entire disk. But what if you don't want to share everything on this drive? Strada lets you control access at any level. So if I navigate to this project and then go to my outputs folder, I can press the plus button here, and when I add Collaborator emails, I'm only granting access to this specific directory. The rest of the drive is inaccessible and invisible to anyone invited here. So what does this experience look like to the person you've invited? If we switch to their computer, they will see a Shared With Me section in their Strada account. Under that section, they'll see any drive they've been invited to. If they have access to the whole drive, they can browse the entire shared drive and access all the files. If they have access to only one specific folder, that's the only directory that will show up in the Shared With Me portal. Your collaborators can now click on any asset and instantly watch the files without uploading to a cloud service, which leads us to our second update. Today, we are also announcing peer-to-peer transfers. You know, this might be a good time to consider ditching that cloud transfer service that you're sick of. Strada now lets you transfer files directly from one computer to another without a cloud in the middle. You can download media in two different ways. If a file is in the player, click the download icon in the upper right and initiate a direct transfer. A download progress bar is visible at the bottom of the app. Remember, this file is transferring from the original hard drive that it's stored on. And if you want to transfer a batch of clips, well, you can select a folder containing assets or select multiple clips in the browser. This approach allows you to transfer several assets simultaneously, which will line up in a queue. The queue can be accessed in the Jobs panel in the upper right. The jobs panel will show you the history of progress of all your transfers. Transferring files using Strada is valuable for several reasons. The best reason is that Strada allows the end user to initiate their own transfers. Users with access to shared drives can localize files without having to bother anyone to get them. Second, Strada transfers are peer-to-peer, which means you never have to spend time or money uploading files to a cloud transfer service before anyone can download them. Third, you can view assets before deciding what to download, so you never accidentally download files you might not need. And lastly, you can prioritize which files you want first. For example, if I'm in a time crunch, I can prioritize the most important files before downloading a larger batch. Now, as your team grows, you'll always want to have a reliable remote experience, and that can be achieved by observing some best practices. Hosting a Strada agent requires an Apple Silicon computer. This is because the computer hosting the agent has to convert all these files on the fly, and Apple Silicon machines have built-in chips that make the conversion ultra fast while maintaining super high quality. We've seen great results sharing files from an Apple M2 and M3 computer, often on MacBook Pros. But since you're becoming your own cloud, there is one big question. How many people can remotely play back from your machine hosting the Strada agent? Well, the answer largely lies within your network speeds. Strada essentially needs about 10 megabits of upload bandwidth per simultaneous user. So if you want three collaborators to remotely access and play back three different files at the exact same time, you're gonna need a minimum of 30 megabits of upload bandwidth available. If a fourth person wants to download a file during those three review sessions, there won't be much bandwidth left over to provide them an efficient transfer. That said, this is only the case when it comes to simultaneous playback. You can invite dozens of people to access media on your agent, but simultaneous reviews require 10 megabits to happen concurrently. So users that have gigabit internet or better should be able to host dozens of simultaneous reviews. Now, we're gonna do a deep dive on this in a full episode, but for now, invites and downloading are available today at strada.tech for you to begin using. But then the question is, well, what's next? Coming up later this summer, we're excited to be adding a full commenting experience. This means you can send and receive feedback directly from within Strada, which should speed up the revision process and allow you to get more feedback from the right people in a shorter amount of time. Next up, we've been building a messaging service so you can send direct messages to your collaborators instead of having to communicate using email or text message. This is especially useful for communicating with contractors in one place because you can DM people or build groups to easily communicate throughout departments. Because this experience all takes place within Strada, messages can be directly tied to clips, no matter whose drive they're on. A few more features include synchronous review, so you can watch a simultaneous playback session of assets as a team. We're also adding review links, so you can share specific files with people that aren't invited to your drives. Review links include permissions controls, such as downloading, passwords, and expiration dates. These are all features that our team is working really hard to deliver, and we can't wait to bring them to you. Now, if you have suggestions for new features, please reach out to us. We'd love to hear your feedback. You can also join any of our weekly live onboarding sessions, as well as our Discord server, where you can chat with other Strada users and provide feedback directly to our engineers so that we can make Strada an amazing product together.